Welcome back. So if fat loss is on your spring agenda, I hear it a lot these days, I have some promising news, and it's so ultra simple. I mean, nothing in the body is simple, but this is pretty simple. So there's a 2019 study that was published in Diabetology and Metabolic Syndrome that showed zinc supplementation, zinc, Z-I-N-C, can have a significant impact on body composition changes. That's simple, right? Just this little mineral zinc that we hear about all the time, right? Basically what happened is they took two groups of people, they reduced their calories by 300 daily calories for 15 weeks. And one group took 30 milligrams of zinc, and the other group, the placebo group, they just took a placebo pill. But both groups decreased their calories by 300. And they looked at body weight, waist circumference, hip circumference, as well as blood markers like insulin, apelin, and HSCRP, you know, which is kind of that big inflammatory marker we check all the time with patients, as well as just overall appetite and satiation scores. And as you probably guessed, since I'm saying this is really simple, the zinc supplemented group showed greater gains in all the markers across the board, you know, from decreased insulin resistance to lowered C-reactive protein, decreased appetite scores, greater weight loss, which is what they were really looking at, right? Isn't that amazing? Simply having extra zinc on board can significantly magnify the benefits of a caloric restriction, you know, food routine, right? And we're talking 300 calories. Which is a very modest reduction in calories compared to what a lot of people are doing with these crazy diets out there. And, you know, just the addition of 30 milligrams of zinc, which is also a modest amount of zinc to be added to the food routine, because zinc tends to be depleted with inflammation, depleted with stress, depleted with sickness. And it has been well established that low zinc and low intake and blood levels of zinc, that they're common in individuals who deal with obesity. And so the longer you are zinc deficient, or the longer zinc deficiency is present, the greater the weight gain. And if this is not corrected, then this can make obesity, you know, just like kind of spiral out of control and be really challenging to get out of that spiral of obesity and all the things that go along with it. So this zinc benefit, you know, on weight loss and overcoming obesity, it's thought to be related to the fact that zinc does affect our appetite, and it does have an appetite-regulating response in our body. And when we have sufficient zinc levels, our insulin resistance improves. And if we don't have to push out as much insulin in our body, then guess what? We're not going to be storing stuff all the time. And as you know, zinc is has essential roles in the synthesis of serotonin, which stimulates feelings of satiation and leads just generally to reduced food intake. Because when we're in an obese state, often, you know, the appetite regulation has completely gone haywire because there's so much inflammation in the tissues, the hormones are out of control. And you may have not heard of the molecule called apelin, which I mentioned earlier, but more and more research is suggesting that apelin correlates, and levels of it correlate and potentiate insulin resistance. And so the higher apelin levels are, the more inflammation, the more insulin resistance you have, and unfortunately, the more propensity you're gonna have for obesity and, you know, diabetes and all these kind of things. And just generally, yeah, you know, to accumulate excess fat you do not want to have in your body. So zinc supplementation is shown to bring down and help regulate this apelin levels. And that's A-P-E-L-I-N is apelin. Which is just amazing, right? That this simple little mineral. You know, often we run to, I think, expensive drinks, concoctions, miracle cures, when a simple, easily accessible remedy, you know, could be available, you know, just around the corner. And namely, one of those would be something like zinc, and making sure your zinc levels are optimized so that your body has all the resources to complete the tasks it is expecting itself to complete and knows it needs to complete. Because if our bodies are happy, and feel like they have the resources available to do what they need to do, then they tend to perform in our best interest, which does usually mean things like reducing insulin sensitivity, or mean reducing insulin resistance, reducing inflammation, reducing things like apelin, you know, reducing fat accumulation in our body, and becoming better utilizer of fat as an energy source. And on the and then feeling like, you know, we're satisfied with the meals we consume versus feeling like there's no amount of food I could put in my body that will lead to satisfaction. All right, I'm Dr. Matt. I can't wait to see you guys next time. I hope you guys keep accumulating massive health, and that you know, you take the opportunity to share, like, subscribe, to get obviously vital information out to people that, you know, they can act on right now.